Hello, everyone. Firstly, I wish to thank the organizers for the invitation in this exciting event. I'm really happy to share experiences with colleagues from outside Europe and looking forward to the conversation that is going to follow. So, as visibly put at the title, the challenges I wish to describe here are those raised in the geographical context of Greece and in the disciplinary context of engineering and natural science students. If we immerse ourselves into the Greek context, we can readily acquire a good picture of the challenges faced when teaching research ethics. I struggled to categorize them in terms of organizational level, but in this case, I completely failed. It seems that individual, organizational, and system of science level are in constant interaction. So I avoided to make oversimplified distinctions. Here, I present the challenges, beginning with the most relevant to the Greek academic environment and continuing with a more wider perspective, if I may say, challenges. Engineers and natural scientists in Greek universities are not provided with a course in research ethics. When this becomes a reality, it is usually at a postgraduate level and in the form of a seminar or a series of seminars. In such cases, students are in a phase of their learning process that wish to be more at the laboratory than at a teaching room. They wish, as they say, to make the best out of their time, and it is not uncommon that they find such seminars not the optimal way to spend it. The knowledge they receive in such seminars is fragmented, since they have the time to learn only bits and pieces of a field that is virtually a terra incognita. In addition, faculty members delivering such seminars usually draw their training material from the biomedical sciences, since they do not have the necessary time to prepare customized training material. This is quite typical, but compounds the effect of disinterestedness from the students. So it is not uncommon a reaction that we do not deal with human beings or animals as research subjects. Engineers and most natural science students at this level have been educated to have practical thinking and to apply a certain level of reductionism. It could be said that their research work is seen as just another stop in a long assembly line of knowledge. This approach makes the uptake of the principles of research ethics like justice, respect, and beneficence that have a holistic character a demanding task. Especially the first two, justice and respect, seem not relevant for a researcher that tests the compressive strength of a stainless steel bar or the corrosion resistance of an intermetallic material. Beneficence is more relevant for reasons that we're going to present in a while. A more holistic view of the research comes together with the experience, but that means that valuable time is lost in the meanwhile. Tricks like discussing the underlying causes that led Prometheus in Greek, to bring the divine flame to humans are useful, but also they can lead to the disorientation of the discussion on generic philosophical questions on what is science and knowledge. The fact also that in Greece there is no national research ethics committee with a legal mandate, combined with the fact that the institutional research ethics committees do not make their presence visible to the students, for example, by giving seminars, does not make things easier. I should say that there is a lack of domestic champion in the field of research ethics. The National Bioethics Commission that exists in Greece has a purely consultative role and lacks the necessary workforce. This brings about the value of our involvement in such European or international events. They give us the necessary material and inspiration, and we act like small Prometheus bring it to the Greek students. But there is actually a field that research ethics can really make sense to all engineers and natural science students. That brings into the attention of students the ethical responsibilities of a scientist or of an engineer, dual use, misuse, and abuse of technology. Most students have read something about the discussion, for example, of nuclear technology, and can take part in discussions about research ethics. This is usually an effective hook to draw the attention, but according to my experience, it can also produce a heated debate on politics. This is partially because Greek students are politically conscious. Many of them participate at students' unions that have a strong political orientation. This disorientation, if we may say, on the debate in a context outside academia also does not help the discussion on research ethics, which is sometimes regarded as a trick of the strong countries to bring their research policies in a beautiful mantle. So these were the challenges that we are facing in Greece with respect to teaching research ethics. I would like to thank you for your attention, and I'm looking forward for the discussion that is going to follow. Thank you very much. Hello, everyone. Firstly, I wish to thank the organizers for the invitation in this exciting event. I'm really happy to share experiences with colleagues from outside Europe and looking forward to the conversation that is going to follow. So, as visibly put at the title, the challenges I wish to describe here are those raised in the geographical context of Greece and in the disciplinary context of engineering and natural science students. If we immerse ourselves into the Greek context, we can readily acquire a good picture of the challenges faced when teaching research ethics. I struggled to categorize them in terms of organizational level, but in this case, I completely failed. It seems that individual, organizational, and system of science level are in constant interaction. So I avoided to make oversimplified distinctions. Here, I present the challenges, beginning with the most relevant to the Greek academic environment and continuing with a more wider perspective, if I may say, challenges. Engineers and natural scientists in Greek universities are not provided with a course in research ethics. When this becomes a reality, it is usually at a postgraduate level and in the form of a seminar or a series of seminars. In such cases, students are in a phase of their learning process that wish to be more at the laboratory than at a teaching room. They wish, as they say, to make the best out of their time, and it is not uncommon that they find such seminars not the optimal way to spend it. The knowledge they receive in such seminars is fragmented, since they have the time to learn only bits and pieces of a field that is virtually a terra incognita. In addition, faculty members delivering such seminars usually draw their training material from the biomedical sciences, since they do not have the necessary time to prepare customized training material. This is quite typical, but compounds the effect of disinterestedness from the students. So it is not uncommon a reaction that we do not deal with human beings or animals as research subjects. Engineers and most natural science students at this level have been educated to have practical thinking and to apply a certain level of reductionism. It could be said that their research work is seen as just another stop in a long assembly line of knowledge. This approach makes the uptake of the principles of research ethics like justice, respect, and beneficence that have a holistic character a demanding task. Especially the first two, justice and respect, seem not relevant for a researcher that tests the compressive strength of a stainless steel bar or the corrosion resistance of an intermetallic material. Beneficence is more relevant for reasons that we're going to present in a while. A more holistic view of the research comes together with the experience, but that means that valuable time is lost in the meanwhile. Tricks like discussing the underlying causes that led Prometheus in Greek, to bring the divine flame to humans are useful, but also they can lead to the disorientation of the discussion on generic philosophical questions on what is science and knowledge. The fact also that in Greece there is no national research ethics committee with a legal mandate, combined with the fact that the institutional research ethics committees do not make their presence visible to the students, for example, by giving seminars, does not make things easier. I should say that there is a lack of domestic champion in the field of research ethics. The National Bioethics Commission that exists in Greece has a purely consultative role and lacks the necessary workforce. This brings about the value of our involvement in such European or international events. They give us the necessary material and inspiration, and we act like small Prometheus, bring it to the Greek students. But there is actually a field that research ethics can really make sense to all engineers and natural science students. That brings into the attention of students the ethical responsibilities of a scientist or of an engineer, dual use, misuse, and abuse of technology. Most students have read something about the discussion, for example, of nuclear technology, and can take part in discussions about research ethics. This is usually an effective hook to draw the attention, but according to my experience, it can also produce a heated debate on politics. This is partially because Greek students are politically conscious. Many of them participate at students' unions that have a strong political orientation. This disorientation, if we may say, on the debate in a context outside academia also does not help the discussion on research ethics, which is sometimes regarded as a trick of the strong countries to bring their research policies in a beautiful mantle. So these were the challenges that we are facing in Greece with respect to teaching research ethics. I would like to thank you for your attention, and I'm looking forward for the discussion that is going to follow. Thank you very much.